There have been protests around the world. The food crisis has already brought down one government. In Haiti, it fell after five people were killed in food riots. In Egypt, there are strikes and protests after large increases in the prices of sugar, oil, and pasta. And more protests in Bangladesh, where 30 million people are now said to be at risk of going without daily meals. The cruel fact is that the poorer you are, the more of your income goes on food, and therefore the hungrier you go when prices rise. In the last 3 years, global food prices have almost doubled.
The rapidly escalating crisis of food availability around the world has reached emergency proportions. The World Bank has estimated that the doubling of food prices over the last 3 years could push 100 million people in low-income countries deeper into poverty.
The reason is merely supply and demand. Use land to grow biofuels, for example, and less is available to produce food. High oil prices mean higher food production costs, while more wealth in India and China means more demand for meat and dairy products, which in turn demand more grain-intensive farming. To cap it all, there's drought in wheat producers like Australia and Kazakhstan. It's Christmas for the speculators as prices drive upwards. Corn up by over 30% in the last year, rice by 74%, soya up by 87%, and wheat by a whopping 130%. Correspondents across the world have found similar pictures.
Here in Delhi, the rising price of food is now right at the top of the political agenda. In this market, they've seen rice prices up 50% in the last year. Part of the reason is India's growing middle class consuming more. But this country is also home to half the world's hungry. For them, even a small rise in the price of rice can make a huge difference.
After working all day from, say, 8 o'clock in the morning till 8 in the evening, if you can't even have simple dal and a simple vegetable for your children, even if they're just two kids, it is very sad.
Everything going up, so I don't think at the moment there's any good news for us.
What will that mean for India, do you think?
For India, a lot of problems.
India's response has been to ban the export of some types of rice and cut some import duties. But if food demand continues to grow faster than food production, well, then the future could be shortages, hunger, and the possibility of social unrest. Here in Beijing, China's main worry is simple. It's the same worry this country's had for decades and decades. How on earth do you feed the world's biggest population? Remember, it's been such a big worry that 30 years ago, this country introduced the one-child policy to keep its numbers down to make sure there was enough food for everyone. Now, hundreds of millions of people have been lifted out of poverty, and this is the kind of food that they can now afford to buy. Meat, something they couldn't afford years and years ago. But there's a problem, and I want to illustrate it by coming to the store of Mrs. Min, the butcher here. A year ago, I could come here and buy a kilo of pork for 11 kwai, that's about 80p or so. But now, 1 year later, prices have doubled. If I want a kilo of pork from Mrs. Min, ni hao, I'd have to pay 22 kwai, that's £1.60. She's angry because fewer people now are coming to her store, and ordinary people are angry because they can't really afford this anymore. And that worries the Chinese government.
Here in Egypt, the prices of some basic foods like rice, pasta and oil have almost doubled over the past year. It means that more families have had to rely on this bread, which is heavily subsidized by the state. The price of one of these loaves is just half a penny, a fraction of its real cost to the government.
In recent weeks, there have been long queues in front of bakeries, provoking loud complaints. All the prices are going up. This time last year, there was no problem getting bread, but now it has become much more difficult.
Rising prices have even caused riots in the Nile Delta. Two people were killed when police clashed with workers demanding better pay.
The government here is worried about social unrest, so it has been trying to soften the impact of the price rises. It has added some 15 million names to the list of people eligible to receive subsidized food.
So the short-term need is money for food. The US has released $200 million of emergency food aid, and Gordon Brown had this to say ahead of a meeting with George Bush in Washington.
I think we've got to do something also together about oil prices and about food prices. I think if the world acts together, we can make a difference to this.
But the bigger, longer-term question is whether we can any longer afford to run the world in the way we do.